What is time? Now look, this might seem like a very simple question, but it's a deep problem as we try to look further into the fundamentals of the universe. Time guides so much of our everyday existence. Everything we do, everything we feel is in relation to time. It's how we perceive the world, how we measure our lives. You see me now in relation to time. If I pause, you can feel the time passing. It's palpable. We see our lives as a series of moments in time that are constantly moving forward. But physicists and philosophers have told us that this is not a new thing. They have told us for a very long time that time is the ultimate illusion. It's completely man-made. A jail cell that humanity is forced upon someday, you know. question that Chris Ayer to see that nature tends towards a randomness, that all systems move towards disorder. That the leaves don't fall in these nice little patterns, but they spill onto the sidewalks. And that we must put energy in to move them into these neat little piles. But then the wind comes and blows them away again. No, I love order, believe me. I'm obsessive when it comes to organizing things, like my books and CDs. And maybe I should get rid of those. But there's a comfort in chaos as well. Maybe that's what autumn is then. Comfort and chaos. Melancholy and decay. You know, I breathe more in the autumn. I fall in love in the autumn. I'm sick more in the autumn. I see more clearly everything around me. And heartache and depression are more palpable. But adventures are more surprising and stimulating. And time alone is more productive and inspiring. I feel a deeper connection to the past. I can feel it in my bones. And memory. I become mired in memory. Trying to organize it in my head. Giving it chapters, titles, feelings, injecting some order into it. I forget the present entirely for days, just to stumble through my own past to find some sort of pattern to meaning. Why does autumn do this? It's a beautiful, awkward time. I'm sure you know what I mean. But I want to live in the present. I want to be here now. You know, if I wasn't so held down by the past, I would have less problems than I do right now. I would be able to march forward free from these memories, both good and bad. But every space I enter, every street I walk down, is laden with memories. And I can't help but be drawn back into them in the autumn. You know, we define ourselves by the spaces we pass through, right? The beds we sleep in, the paths we take to work. If I enter a hotel that I've been in before, it retains the residue of past moments so distinctly that my mood can change entirely upon crossing the threshold. I mean, even this theater may have memories for you that have nothing to do with what I'm saying. That may have nothing to do with this theater, even. You know, our perception of everything is built on prior knowledge, right? The compounding of memories, placing emotional space into physical space, and observing the world through our own particularly shaded glasses. It's no wonder people see ghosts. The space itself conjures up hallucinations in the past, manifests itself. If I ask a ghost to appear here right now, will it come? And which of you will see it?